Seek kindly about this, and one day it will be you. but I can't accept this ending as it's time for me to leave. But please, no cake for the reception, to enjoy my drink. This way. A little bit about Kevin. Kevin was born in 1957, to the proud parents of Pam and Lucy. His family became complete when they welcomed his sister Lindsay just a few years later. He had a happy childhood growing up in the Anchorage countryside, where he enjoyed playing outside, watching trains, and trying to play tricks. But I must add that Lynn was quite aware of these little things, and she was very warm for them. She enjoyed anything practical, and always seemed to be happy when having some sort of project on the go. Whether that was collecting three stones on holiday, which she would later have polished and used to make beautiful jewellery, or watching trains, or going fishing instead. His love for all things practical was on occasion reflected in school report. He was particularly proud of the 1964. Inside, he could be a silly little boy. But maybe that was just the foundation of starting someone who later demonstrated a warm heart, a great sense of humour, and created laughter wherever he went. One person who knows Kevin very well is that of Dawn, his daughter. Dawn has kindly written the eulogy for Lenny ceremony. She would like to share with her. Dad was the light of my life. Even a little girl, I remember him making me laugh so much I nearly cried. He had a great sense of humour that rubbed off on anyone who was near him. Although he did have a serious guy too. That in the room was all the world that was working, right? I don't even know there were printers. Dad must have done someone so hard his foot got stuck. Dad grew up in the country, but he wasn't a villager. He nodded a point to anyone who could act in the village, but it is indeed a town. Dad spoke to his fond memories living on West Street with the strawberry line at the end of his backyard. Only a few weeks ago, he told us of times when he would injure himself, which I'm sure was many based on how much of an explorer he was. His mum would write the train time and number on his starter. Dead love of trees followed him throughout his life, but quite often read a mad the train number. But a moment I would outstanding engineer, precise and proud of what he did, and he passed on to my brother David, who changed with his year of engineering. As a little girl, I remember sitting and waiting for school in the garage at staff home, asking Dad, what are you making? And the answer would always be the same. A tool to get Boy Scouts out on my harvester. But I still to this day do not know what he was making. I'm sure many of you have your own stories to tell, either at the machine shops in Western, or within the walls of EW estate. And I'm sure the corridor of the camp he required without you. Dad was always so kind to give us. He took us on amazing adventures around the world, sometimes reckless, but always amazing. Tim and David would go fishing and come back with tales of giant lizards digging their bait and catching everything but fish, including turtles, swans and ducks, even a robin, but I can assure you no animals were ever injured. This often ended up in wet clothes, where Dad would end up in the water. I'm sure many of you have seen the photo of Dad in his pants in the field, but if not, we'll be sure to make this one public. We all have many fond memories of travel with Dad. When I think of them, I can't help but laugh. Many times, he's following me around the airport, so frustrated, shouting, "Dawn, Dawn, Dawn!" or asked 100 times if we had bought the passport to take it. We always said, if we could have a superpower, it would be to click our fingers and just see somewhere in a flash. I hope you're doing that now, Dad. I hope you're flying high in all the things you love. I hope you're at Cape Greco, Bakery Bay, the Leaven of Beast and Connor. I hope you're in Florida, collecting starfish and sand dollars who have lost their way, and guiding them back into the sea. Okay, so that's the hill, driving down that block and just running wild. Wherever you may be, I hope you'll grab up and thank you. Thank you for your love, your patience, your understanding, your wisdom, and your amazing sense of humour. You have given us a gift that's more precious than anything in the world. Goodbye, Dad. You will always live on in our hearts and will love you forever. Your eyes, my eyes. P.S. So I hope you have a choice. Take care, Grumpy. Love you. Kevin was clearly a spooky bandit, born and aided, and made him fellow Grumpy to Agnes Joy, a spoken stepdad to Amy and Lewis, and a loving husband and best friend to Andrew. Andrew, Amy, and Lewis have written a beautiful letter to Kevin, and I'd like to read it on their behalf. It's called our thank you letter. Thank you. Thank you for coming into our lives for your sense of happiness, love, and laughter. Thank you for the amazing holidays and adventures we have shared. Our favourite special place was only Bora Farm in Cornwall, where we had lots of happy holidays, making memories. We spent many wonderful days and years with farm dogs Charlie and Coco, and slowly filling them to the leaflets of our own dog, Nala, the crazy cockatoo. We loved her as much as we did, even though we had your own special name. Thank you for showing us some of your most amazingly funny Mr. Angry moments. From removing the fish from the bin when we missed tea, and then trying to reheat it by taking it to the room. That man is incredible. And at the moment, it is sitting on the floor and throwing your glasses across the room in a little fashion. And then they ricochet off the wall but land back on your head. These would make you so mad, but then catching us with our shoulders going up in bed and laughing hysterically, always would you laugh too. Don't let you get started on your DIY or your recycling. I'm sure our neighbours still talk about you standing in the meeting and trying to outstand the engineer, precise and proud of what he did. And he can't. Thank you for teaching us so much. Your views and ideas live on in Lewis. Will you have many debates and discussions with, often whilst doing a ritual. Thank you for just being you, the most funny, generous, loyal, honest, kind, and brave person we have ever had the pleasure to meet, our wonderful husband and stepdad. But most of all, thank you for loving us and giving us a lifetime of happy memories, which we will treasure always. We have heard just a few of the wonderful messages and anecdotes of Kevin. So now let us take a few moments to reflect on his life. We will be meeting him in your own way. Think of the many experiences you shared, the love, the laughter, your time spent together. Most of all, we met with Kevin as he was. We are reflecting and remembering we should receive to receive the picture of my energy.
I'll be glad that I was meant to live too heavy.
Richard Edgington. Today, he has smiled to contribute and recall special memories. Your life is a living and lasting memory that our grateful hearts will treasure. Our years with you have been filled with precious moments, happy memories, friendships formed, and good times shared. In the tomorrow still to come, we will walk beside us in the sunshine and the rain. We will hear you in the whispers of the wind and the silence of our thoughts. We will speak your name often, and we will close our eyes and smile because of the life we live. We will miss you, but we will treasure and remember all the days gone before that we were privileged to share with you. We will continue to live on in all our hearts. And now, in sorrow, we commit your body to be cremated, that with love we release your spirit to be free. Kevin, we hold you in our hearts from this day forward. We carry your memory with us always. Continue your journey with the love of everyone here. May your love be with all who need it. So stay free, go in peace, and go in love. Still maintaining the ability to share humour and love to all those around him. Andrew and Dawn met every day by Kevin's side, and both friendly and resident hospital, and finally at resident care. In his last 2 weeks, they were joined by Lewis. The visits he had from all of his family and friends during this time really helped maintain his spirit, and he gave him a feeling of love, comfort, and peace. Special memories were made, and they still manage lots of laughter along with tears. One particular gift from Lindsay was to make handcuffs with Kevin, a gift which not only created laughter along with them, but provided great entertainment amongst staff, but more importantly, left a cherished keepsake for the family to look back on in years to come. I don't dare say that Kevin received the best care from his staff at hospice, and his cousin Deborah in particular would spend time after the shift with him. The family feels that this love, compassion, and support demonstrated by Deborah and the team at the hospice gave Kevin the ability to feel comfort, which enabled his personality to shine. And as a way of saying thank you, the family would like to ask that any donations in lieu of flowers be gifted to this wonderful local charity, which helps so many families and communities in South Africa. It has been a privilege to be part of the warmth, love and memory shared here today. I would like to close with a poem, which I feel Kevin will be asking of you all, and it's called Afterglow by Helen and Melanie Marshall. I'd like the memory of me to be a happy one. I'd like to see an afterglow of a smile when life is done. I'd like to leave an echo whispering softly down the ways of happy times and laughing times and bright and gay. I let the tears of those who grieve to dry all the of happy memories that I leave when my children. The best tribute we can undertake, Kevin, is to carry forward and share those precious memories. Hold on to him and support.
but no means part of him. Talk about the monster. Laugh at things he was a laughter, and enjoy your memories of him. Just as we have here today, when he really wants in your heart. Finish with a quote from Helen Keller. What we once enjoyed and deeply loved, we will never lose. But all that we love, we will become part of us.
Thank you.
hold on to him.